Ever have a nagging health problem that doesn't seem to go away no matter what you do? If you have, this and my last two videos on detoxification may be the most important videos you look at for your health. To see these videos, subscribe to this channel at AskDrShintani.com, look for my previous videos, and click on the bell for notifications of the next videos to come. In this video, I'll describe 6 more ways to detoxify. The last two may be the most important ways you can use. Hi, this is Dr. Shintani for your health. If you've tried everything to get rid of that nagging fatigue or pain or rash or any health problem that you can't seem to get rid of, detox may be the most important things you can do. In my new paradigm of health, avoiding toxins and detoxification is one of the first things to consider in optimizing your health. Let me tell you a quick story about how important this can be. One of my colleagues is a well-known nutrition expert, but he was dying of a strange neurological disease that they thought was a variant of Lou Gehrig's disease. He was gradually becoming paralyzed about his mouth and throat, and they thought that soon he'd be unable to speak, swallow, or even breathe properly, and eventually die of this disease. No medication seemed to slow the progress of this disease. It turns out that he had high levels of dioxin in his body because he'd done research on dioxin in his earlier years. When he undertook a detox program, the disease disappeared, and 25 years later, he's alive and well, with no sign of this disease at all. This is how important detox can be. So here are 6 more ways to detox. Number 7, skin scrub. A skin scrub, especially during a hot bath or a hot shower, is also helpful in detox because it opens up the capillaries near the surface of the skin and increases blood flow to the skin. This helps to increase the amount of toxins that may be eliminated through perspiration and enhances the detoxification functions of the skin. Using a scrub towel or a loofah sponge can be useful in this process. Adding salt to the scrub is also helpful. Number 8, boosting bodily energy. Giving your body more energy helps your body to do its own house cleaning at the cellular level. One way to do this is to exercise regularly. Another important factor is to eat properly to optimize cellular health. Yet another way is to make sure your hormones are optimized, especially your thyroid hormone, which controls your metabolism. Energy medicine is another way that may be effective in boosting energy. One promising system is Bioscalar Energy, which I'm publishing research about. The only Bioscalar system currently validated is the Bioscalar Energy Enhancement System developed by Dr. Sandra Rose Michael. There's evidence that it boosts cellular energy and helps the body to push toxins into the bloodstream to be cleared out by the 6 organs of detoxification. By the way, there are a lot of phony scalar energy products and systems that are unvalidated. One of them claims to destroy viruses and pathogens at a distance. This is an irresponsible claim because it may persuade people to not take effective medication and replace it with their sham scalar energy. So be careful when you hear such claims. Number 9, attitudinal healing. This is a concept pioneered by psychiatrist Jerry Jampolsky. It is getting rid of toxic attitudes. Attitudinal healing provides a different kind of detox. It helps to detoxify your body of negative thought patterns and helps to decrease toxic emotions and stress. Toxic thoughts can create toxic stress-related substances in the body and can promote inflammation, which is the key component of many diseases. To see the 12 principles of attitudinal healing, go to www.ahhawaii.org. Meditation can also shut down negative thought processes, reduce stress, and enhance all other detox functions in the body. Number 10, replace drugs with natural substances. Many medications can cause a lot of health problems, partly because they tend to be synthetic substances, and they all have some side effects. For example, to help deal with the opioid crisis, a lot of people are choosing hemp oil or cannabidiol for anxiety, pain, and sleep instead of using opioids, Valium, or sleeping pills, or other addictive drugs. See my previous video about CBD hemp oil. Make sure you don't stop taking prescription medications without consulting your doctor first. The last two ways may be the simplest and most effective detoxification things you can do. Number 11 is exercise. Exercise is one of the best detoxification activities because it's simple to do. Exercise helps your whole body to detoxify by accelerating all six organs of detoxification. It forces you to deep breathe. It increases circulation so that the kidneys and liver can process more toxins in the body. It induces sweating so that detox through the skin can occur more efficiently. It can resolve constipation and improve digestion, and it can boost the immune system. Number 12, along with exercise, fasting may be the other best detoxification practice. It allows the body's input functions to rest and allows the output functions to operate uninterrupted for a while. There are many ways to fast. Look for my future videos on fasting, including the latest on intermittent fasting. In my next video, I'll discuss supplements that can enhance detoxification and the mechanisms by which they work. For more tips on health and vibrant longevity, subscribe to this channel and click on the bell for notifications. This is Dr. Shintani for your health.